So our existing ground is defined by these gray contour lines on the site plan, these here, and to define the existing ground from these gray contours in Kubla Cubed as well, we make sure the existing tab is selected, and then we add a feature surface. Now for this existing surface, what we need to define is the outline and the contour lines. For the site outline, I will draw around the boundary of the site. Sometimes Kubla Cubed users get confused when defining this phase, because they assume that they have to draw the outline for the existing on top of the line that defines the limits of disturbance. So they think that the outline should be this one. This is not the case, and it is absolutely fine for your existing ground to extend the limits of disturbance. So I'm going to draw the boundary for the site according to the area that is included within these 4 points here. Even though a part of it is not earthworks related like this one here. So I click on this button. Then we'll click on draw, and then choose the extrapolate option, which is almost always the case to define the existing ground. What the extrapolate option does is taking the levels of the features inside the outline to define the levels of the outline itself. In this case, it takes its levels from the contour line levels I'm about to draw. So I begin drawing. I click on each vertex. Here, and then I right click or press enter to finish. Right. Now I'm going to draw my contours. It is similar to drawing the outline, how you draw the contours, except for the fact that after you finish every line, you type in the level in order to complete it. So I am going here, and I will start drawing my contour lines. So I'm starting here. I want to be very precise so that my ground is very accurate. Right, in order to complete, you right click and then you type in the level. And click enter and you go to the next. If I make a mistake, if I go here, then with backspace I can always correct and do it again. And you can repeat it as many times as you need to. Now, after completing the first contour line, you will see this text appearing here. It gives you the opportunity to press the up and down key in order to derive the contour level from the previous one you've typed. This can be really helpful and save you a lot of time where your site runs up or down a slope, as this one does. So the software will guess the increment here, but you can click and overtype it if it's not correct. In our case, the 1 foot is wrong because it should be half a foot. So I correct it, and then I go here and click the up arrow, and I have my correct level, and I click on enter and I continue to the next one. So I'm almost done. This is the second to the last. And this is the last. Finished. Now that I've completed all my contour lines and along with the outline, this is all I need to define my existing levels. So I am going to click on the OK button and the software will generate a surface. Now this is the existing ground from these levels.